the studio, going through a lot of the stuff you were up going through in your life, and with the band too, with the band changes and all that stuff, what was the recording process like for the new album?
Hell.
It was
me sitting at home by myself a lot. Just the band had heard already about it so much, you know, the band had seen me go through so much turmoil with my marriage and stuff that they were just kind of like, I don't really know how to react to it, you know. I'd give them 40 songs every, you know, something like that. I'd give them like 40 fucking songs, excuse my language. I'd give them like 40 fucking songs, and when we'd hit the road for Approaching Normal. They're like, what are you doing? 40 songs. It's like, it's our next album. We got to start working on it. I'm like, okay, dude. So they put it in their thing, and I don't think any of them really listened to it. But then when it got time to rehearse, it got heated, you know? It was like, why don't you know these 40 fucking songs? And they were like, are you kidding? Are you serious? I'm like, man, let's just at least talk about the songs. And at first it was very like, Justin, you can't really say that stuff, man. You can't go do that, you know? And I was like, why? When we could talk about drugs, we could talk about priests raping kids, we could talk about my cousins, we could talk about everybody's life, we could talk about my drug habits, we could talk about my past, we could talk about abuse, we could talk about all this stuff. But when it comes down to something that could possibly be the biggest center point in my life, my child, I can't talk about it. And it was just like, wow, it was a big eye-opener. For a second, I didn't know what was going to happen, because I was just like, I'm just going to keep recording. I'm going to keep recording. If you want to come over, come over. You know, so the door's always unlocked. I always knew there's a key right by the water hose. And but I also find that it's a very touchy situation. You know, it's a very touchy thing. But when you're in Blue October, you have to be ready to talk about anything. That's how I've always been.
I'm like a ghost. I'll be living in a dirt room, waiting for the day to be closer to the window in your home. I'll be standing by your back door, reaching for the knife in my coat. I'm gonna put it to your throat. You sweaty piggy, you're a bad man. What a fucking sad way to go. Your mother raised you as a show. I should've wiped away a bird and used the curtain in the kitchen to choke.
But ever since I saw the Pope stand up and said, I have no comment, I've been just like, you know what, fuck this world. It's just, it's on. I'm going to talk the truth about anything. I'm not doing it like, ooh, I'm so fucking cool. Because I would hate for anybody to have to go through a 3-year divorce in a custody battle like we have. And I've just always known to tell the truth. And coming around to your first original question, how was the recording process like? It was like, and I'm being honest, and if anybody in the band or anybody sees this, it was just like every, I don't want to sound like a dick, but every day I felt like I had to, no. Hold on. I told this list last week was not supposed to be there. Why is it there this week? Well, we recorded a little bit. You recorded a little bit guitars when? Let me hear that. Why'd you take that part? Switch it back. You know, you'll see what I mean in the end. Just trust me. And, you know, we had CB who couldn't hang with it, you know, but he wanted to have a family also. And I commend that, and I love CB, but he didn't really understand where I was going with it, and neither did anybody. You know, that's why I invested in it on my own. Don't nobody put your money into this. This is all going to be my money. So when it goes down, it's like, I don't want to hear anybody go, oh, well, I'm getting sued by your ex-wife. Well, no, I'm getting sued. And if you're getting sued, there's a problem, because you shouldn't have invested any fucking money in this thing. I told you that. But if I see you in court, I guess our relationship's over with. But the thing is it's such an honest to God, it's the best thing I've ever done in my life.
Was it therapy for you in there writing it day to day as it's happening?
As it was happening. That was what was so honest about it, is that it was me sitting there going, wait, why am I approaching normal? Why am I recording Approaching Normal during the day? And at night, I can't wait to drive home and get in there and talk about what just was said on the phone that day, just to fuck my day up. But during Approaching Normal, I'd go home and I'd write, and it'd be my little four-cornered room. And inside of the album, if you look at it, it has a picture of the room that I sat in for literally 2.5 years. And just fell apart, just at the seams. very hard to record this album because it was all so real. And if it ever got fake, then I made sure I cut it. And seriously, people hold grudges against me today for this album and the recordings just because I was a fucking dick. But it's about my daughter. I had to have it perfect. And there was no bullshit. You can't just, hey, how does this lick sound? No. It's calculated, bum, 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 bum. And everybody in the band is so talented that I know they could. And I knew they could do it. And once they got a hold of it and started hearing Tim Palmer joined in, that's when it was like, Tim Palmer was a single father himself. So he was like, no. What the fuck are y'all talking about? He can't say that. You're saying it. And you're going to say, stand with your dick in your hand and acting like a pussy, man, because I think it sounds good. And I was like, okay, cool. You know, this is great. This was a Tim and I project.
Yeah, so how was that kind of working with him, someone who's kind of disconnected, not a member of the band?
Perfectly beautiful. Well, there was a point when he goes, this isn't your solo project. And I was like, stop it. I know it's not. It's not a democracy either. It's not something that, if nobody's in here, do you see anybody else in here right now? Then it looks like you and I are making an album together. And he goes, I think he got frustrated because he didn't understand hip-hop side of it. I'm a very big hip-hop fan. He's a very big rock fan. He did 10 from Pearl Jam, for Christ's sake. The man's a genius, dude. So I had to respect him, and I had to go, dude, if I don't get what I want out of that, the prickiest thing I ever said. Oh, my God, I can't believe I said it to Tim. He's going to kill me. I said, if this song doesn't come out the way I want it, I will strip everything clean and do it on piano solo. Boom. How you like that for solo? And he goes, all right. I like it that we can argue. And I love the man. Because he'd drive home later that night and go, I believe in you, man. I believe in it. Are you all right? Are you all right? And I'm like, I'm fine. I get this way. And you're foiled. I got the same way. So just leave me alone. You know, we'll be fine. And Tim was so good. Tim was so great. And he was so like, I remember I was doing the divorce. I'd fly back and fly forth. I'd have guitar parts. And there were Tim playing the guitar. And I was like, he's like Johnny Marr in the band. I was like, holy shit, dude. It was really fucking cool. He was a genius. So tell me all the things you told me we could be through understanding. Try forgiveness, but face the facts. It's what I witnessed. Why do I only feel it's just when I'm with you? I only hear your words to say it's true. You keep thinking it over.
What is the most emotional song to you?
The Worry List.
Yeah.
Worry List. Because it's just like, it's to all my homeboys and to all my good friends that were sitting there watching it the whole time going, dude, when the fuck is this chick gonna let up? When are they going to give him some peace, for Christ's sake? And it's the ones that never really got annoyed with it, because I was annoyed with it 3 years ago. You know, just leave me alone, let me go my way. But when Blue's going to be able to hear that, you know, one day, and that she'll be able to hear all the other stuff, but it's just, I think that's the most special song I've ever written in my whole life, that and Feel Again. Those two songs are my two favorite songs I've ever written. It's a certain amount of coolness to do of being a father. When I'm walking through Chicago O'Hare with my daughter in hand, I feel cool. Because she's got a little black t-shirt on, I got my little black t-shirt on, and she's so cute because she's like, excuse me. She can wave through those crowds like nobody's business. Shared parenting is basically when a child is born, they're given the 50% of the time to the mother and the father, unless they're not fit parents. Fit parents mean they're not on drugs, they're out working, they're doing good, saving, they're logical, good, common sense, wonderful parents like yourself. And most of the towns were asking senators to come out, state representatives, things like that. And so far we've had, five? We've had five or four representatives come out. Senator Phoenix, I went and took pictures with her. State Representative Oregon, Senator from Washington. We had a Minnesota, and then we had the law guy. The lawyer from Denver, top family lawyer from Denver, came in, and he was like dressed like a cowboy, man. And he got up there, and he's like, I'm here to support Justin. And I was like, wow, Young Guns. It was kick-ass. Thorne was his name. What a badass name. And we're basically getting a lot of good people together. And And we're not fighting anything. We're just really wanting what's right in America.
Right.
You know, is that fathers play a huge part. And last night we had a very touching lady. She got up there, and Peggy Stone. And she got up there, and she spoke just about how, from a woman's point of view. So it was really cool to see the people in the audience, not just see another man up there, see a woman talk about it. And she was just boom, 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 fact after fact, and it was awesome. So,
do you think it's easier to, as a band, to kind of spread awareness? I know you guys have done a lot with suicide prevention, obviously the Fatherhood Coalition. As a band trying to spread a message, is it easier coming from an artist as opposed to some politician or someone telling you?
That's if it comes from your first question, how was recording, if everybody's backing you. If you're doing it by yourself, you look like a stupid, crazy man. If you have your team backing you and you have people backing you, then it doesn't look like one single dude losing his mind. For a while there, it was one single dude losing his mind, but that's what got me the album. Now I have people going, oh, this has helped me heal. But if you have a team that helps you and lifts you up and gets you out of bed every day, and people see that on stage, they take you seriously. If you're just up there going, ah, I'm losing my fucking mind, which I am, you know. But if you have a team, you know, so I think anybody could change things. They just got to get off their ass and do it.